In this video, I'll be showing how to get all diamond things in Roblox Islands. So that means diamonds, enchanted diamonds, the diamond block, diamond axe and pickaxe, diamond sword, diamond hammer, and the diamond mines portal. So make sure to subscribe with the notifications on for more islands videos and like the video. But first, you're gonna need to be level 50 for combat. And if you're not level 50 yet, then you can either just trade for diamonds, or you can AFK auto farm all of the mobs, which I linked in the description a guide on how to do that. Well, not all of the mobs, because the new mob can't really be AFK auto farmed, and it only respawns like 1 hour or 30 minutes every time, so it wouldn't really be that efficient to AFK auto farm, as scorps are more efficient for that. But to get diamonds, you need to go over to the Bufflepore Island. So you're gonna need to be at least level 16 to go here, then level 50 to get to the other place. I'm not gonna fast forward this part so everyone knows exactly where to go, but you want to go past this rock thing right here. Then there's gonna be a tunnel, so just go down there. Then there are gonna be these pillars, and go inside of the thing that says Diamond Mines. Then there's gonna be the miner building and the miner guy. So if you turn right, that is going to be the end of the tunnel because it just like loops around. So you want to turn left. And once you get past this part, just go forwards and then keep going forwards until you see this area that you can turn, and there are gonna be more pillars there. So after that, you want to go through this tunnel right here. Then in this room, if you turn this way, that is just going to go back to the main area. So you want to keep going this way, not that way though, because that is going to lead back to the main area too. Then there's going to be this part where there are like big caves and stuff. And this is where you want to do the fight with the new mob called Core. Then there are going to be these pillars. Then boss fight F summon core. But if you notice, this is like the same exact menu, or very similar to the 2018 Egg Hunt game, so maybe they're gonna do something with eggs here. That might be what's in the Egg Hunt here, but just hold F, then that is going to spawn the core. Now, what you wanna do is like be very careful with this guy because he's really overpowered. I think he's hacking. If you're in a server with other players, then he might not really move that much because of lag, but you want to try to avoid all his attacks. Sometimes he does this angry stomping thing, so you just want to run back like every time he's about to do that, but just spam him a whole bunch with the Rage Blade or whatever weapon you're using. I don't know, I guess the bows would be super overpowered here because you could just stand kind of far away. Uh-oh, that was kind of close. Oh, no, don't do that. Okay, so we almost got him to half health. Just want to keep spamming him with the Rage Blade. Uh-oh, that's not good either. Uh-oh. Oh, that's the stomping thing. Or you can just like jump over that right when he does it. But this is actually a pretty easy attack. I've only been hit once because I didn't think he was doing the stomping thing. Hope he doesn't do the stomping thing soon because like I'm probably going to get hit by it. Uh-oh. And sometimes it's laggy, so you might not be able to jump over it. Even if like it doesn't spawn, then it just spawns really fast and goes past you. But the Rage Blade stopped working. Uh-oh, that's not good at all. He fell over. What is he doing? Just fell into the ground and didn't attack. Okay, there we go. And I got a yellow jukebox disc. So once you do that, he is going to spawn diamonds, and you're gonna get 9,999 XP from that for combat and whatever weapon you're using. So you just want to mine the diamonds. You're gonna get 450 XP per diamond though for mining, so that is kind of good. But I mean, you could just farm gold and probably get a good amount too from that because, like, these have a lot of health and they're kind of harder to find. But I guess if you want to farm mining XP, this is the best place to do it. So let's just get that other diamond there. Then I think those were all the diamonds. Yep. And how you get enchanted diamonds, I'm 99% sure that it's just a rare drop. Like, whenever you mine iron, how sometimes you get crystallized iron, it's kind of like that. And I think it's maybe a 1 in 10 chance or 1 in 25 chance, maybe even lower, like 1 in 50 or somewhere around there. But diamonds can actually spawn inside of the mine. So you see how there's gold here? Well, sometimes in these spawns, like how on Bufflepore Island, sometimes gold spawns. It's not really that hard to get though. Wait, is this a secret area? Nope, it's just the bottom place of this. But yeah, sometimes diamonds will spawn, so just wander around the mines and you'll probably find diamonds at some point. I only found one diamond in the mines, so it may take a little bit of time, but they are definitely very good, and it's probably better to just run around the mines, like while you're waiting the hour 30 minutes, because you could probably get like a decent amount of diamonds. I mean, you could probably try to AFK auto farm diamonds, but you'd have to AFK auto farm just one of the spawns here, and it takes a while to respawn, so that wouldn't be efficient at all. But I guess that's it for the first part of just how to get diamonds and enchanted diamonds. Then for the diamond mines portal shard, you're gonna need to just fight the core, and I'm pretty sure it's a rare drop because like the shards are going for like 30 million right now, sometimes even more. The hype is definitely gonna drop, and they're probably gonna be like 10 million at some point soon. But you can craft it if you go over to the workbench, and then it is going to be with other portals. It's the fifth one there. And you need one diamond mines portal shard, 15 enchanted diamonds, and then 150 stone brick. Then to get the other things, so if you go over to skills, you can see for mining, it is level 62. And I do not know anyone who is over level like 55, because it takes about an hour or two just to level up once you get to around level 50. Because not only did they nerf pickaxes and axes whenever they added the update where like mining is faster, but it does way less damage, but they also made it so that gold, electrite, and basically all ores give less XP. So they nerfed it in both ways that they could nerf it. And they're wanting people to be level 60 to craft this. So at least they nerfed the Gilded Steel pickaxe level, and now it's only level 50. But this is definitely way too high. I think they should do it like how they have wood cutting though, because wood cutting you only need level 46 for that. And then Gilded Steel Axe, wait, it was 25 before, now it's level 32, so they made it harder to be able to craft the Gilded Steel Axe. But I think they should just make it so that under mining you only need level 32 for the Gilded Steel pickaxe and then 48 for the regular pickaxe. But for wood cutting, like I already showed, you only need to be level 46, so I do have it unlocked already, but you need a lot of gilded, or wait, no, I already have enough diamonds. I think they nerfed it because I remember it needing enchanted diamonds earlier. So I guess the pickaxe is the same. But Gilded Steel Rods, 3 out of 5, so I do need 2 more of those. I guess we can make that this video and I can show you guys it. So let me make 5 just in case, because I'm probably gonna need some later. And then now I can get the Diamond Axe. I'll probably do a video showcasing all of these. But then the regular axe, it does like maybe 2/5, and then the Diamond Axe. Oh, that is significantly better. Okay, yeah, that does a bit more. But I mean, my wood farm, I only need to destroy the grass block below that, but I could, wait, so that's gonna be 2 shots instead. So I guess it's gonna be better even if you do the wood farm where you have the tree on top of the grass block and you destroy the grass below it. So that is pretty good. And so I guess I have the diamond axe now. Now I just need to get to mining level 62 for the pickaxe. But to get the axe, and I'm again pretty sure that the pickaxe will have the same exact things where you just need that amount of diamonds and gilded steel rods. Wait, I don't know why you need gilded steel rods because it isn't even gilded. Like nothing on this is gilded, it's just diamonds. But to get gold, you can fight Bupplecore or you can go over to Bupplecore Wizard and the new Mines Island. And then there are going to be some ores that spawn there, then you can just mine the ores. Definitely spawns the most on the mine island, so if you're level 50, you're gonna be able to get gold the fastest from doing that. Then it's gonna give gold ore, so you just put that in the smelter, or on your gold deposit island, you can do what I did, where you put a smelter after that. Then you have input-output chests, and then that is also pretty efficient, but you're just gonna need a little bit of gold. Then steel, you need a steel mill. And then you can put iron totems, a conveyor, and then coal behind it so that it does that. But I'm pretty sure you all already know how to make steel and the Gilded Steel Rods, though. Then there are the new weapons. So they didn't add like 2 of the light melee weapons and the staff. So maybe they're fixing the magic things before they're adding the staff. And they're gonna wait until later to add the light melee stuff because they don't want to add like a whole bunch of light melee things. But there's the diamond warhammer, and you're gonna need 80 diamonds, 5 gilded steel rods, and 10 enchanted diamonds. I talked to one of the staff, and they said that the diamond warhammer does more damage than the diamond greatsword, but I'm pretty sure that the diamond greatsword is going to attack faster, and also it would make sense if the hammer does more, because like way more people farm the light melee XP, and it is way easier to get light melee XP because the most overpowered weapons are light melee weapons. So You're gonna need the same amount for both, though, so I suggest if you want to do more damage, get the Diamond Warhammer. If you want to attack faster, then maybe get the Diamond Greatsword. But I already explained how to get Gilded Steel Rods, and I already explained Enchanted Diamonds, where you just farm the diamonds and it's a rare drop. Then the Diamond Warhammer, too, it's the same. So I guess that's how to get all the diamond things. All right, there's one more thing. So the diamond block, you gotta go over to this area right here and then scroll down a bit. And I don't know why it's different. Like, it seems like since they combine things, like if you click on certain things, it's combined. For example, with the portals, it shows all the different portals here. I don't know why iron, gold, and diamond are separate, and coal, but the diamond block right here is only 10 diamonds. And it looks a lot like the sea lantern. Like, if you place a sea lantern, it's slightly green, but it's bright too because it's a lantern. Then the diamond block actually looks way better. I think the diamond block looks really cool. The sea lantern looks like an off-brand diamond block, kind of. But the diamond block also has a lot of health. And wait, I wonder if this is gonna do more damage to it than the pickaxe. Wait, let's just see that. Okay. I think the regular axe does more damage to the diamond block than the pickaxe. That is, yeah, I really want to get that pickaxe. But I'm probably gonna change some of my things at my base to be built out of diamonds. Like, replace all of the gold with diamonds just because I think it will look nice. But diamonds are actually kind of hard to get because they take a while to get. But that is gonna be it for this video. Some people are asking me about if I'm gonna make a value list soon. Well, I'm gonna do the value list guide for this update probably tomorrow, maybe the day afterwards. But right now, the prices are still pretty random. Like, the portal shard is being traded for at lowest 10 million, at highest, like, 75 million, and it's being sold and bought for that much. And I just lost internet connection for some reason. But make sure to subscribe with the notifications on for more Islands videos, like the video, join the Discord server linked in the description, follow my Twitter at Telanthric, use star code Telanthric to support my channel, and linked in the description is a guide called Roblox Islands Guide that has all my helpful Islands videos on it. So if you need help with anything, then check that out because it's probably there, but I'll see you all in the next video.